it speaks to sort of the next generation, where we're moving forward, how do we create space for all voices, and it's really wonderful to have all of you guys here tonight, and I hope to see you at all of our programming that's going to be associated with the Pizza. And so I want to give now the mic over to the artist, and then we'll do the raffle afterwards. So,
what?
I love that! So, without further ado, Los Artistas, Jesús, Melanie, Fabiana, and I want to thank Malakias too for designing the postcard, but you'll talk
So this is all the work that's been printed in the Taller Tupac Amaru. And the Taller Tupac Amaru, like you said, 10 years ago in 2003, started when working with Fabiana and Estria Miyashiro, who's now living in Hawaii. We had kind of already been working together and doing a little bit of screen printing, and we had the idea of like starting up our own studio, really inspired by the work of the previous generations that came before us. Like Malakias, who's really been a big proponent of the Tayed way of working with stuff. And so when we started this, we had really like one intention, to work with community and to be able to really elevate the screen printed artwork. And it wasn't just about making the political posters, but we also wanted to work with artists who were doing really, really chingon stuff. Like Malakias and Estén and Rupert Garcia and Manuel Montoya and so many other artists that we haven't had an opportunity to work with. But this is really, you know, a showcase of what we've been doing in the past 10 years. And it's really, I think, a really big accomplishment for us to have all this work. And really, to me, I owe all this to the generation that came before us and really set it up so that we could do this. Because before that, when you were young and Chicano or you're Mexicano and you looked up to the art world, and you know, you didn't see yourself before, like, you know, artists like Malakias and Estén and Emmanuel and Juan and Rupert were there. You know, they didn't have that. They didn't have other people like them to look up to, but we did, and we were really lucky. So we were able to then reproduce what they had started and continue that. And I think that's really the important thing about tonight, is that this is really a continuation of work that started a long time ago, and it's a way of keeping that work going and keeping it for the next generation. And the other artists that are in here that are young artists, it's really great to have been able to work with them and like kind of put them in that same trajectory that we've had. And when me and Fabiana started this, it was really a way for us to be able to put our artwork out there and to have that political voice that we've had as organizers and as an artist, to put it out there. And when Melanie joined us, she's my wife, I don't know if y'all know that, but when she joined us, it was really...
You're my husband!
That's also the generation before.
But it was really great to be able to have like this workshop with the three of us and doing what we do.
Yeah.
I really want to thank, you know, all the artists who participated. Like I said, I think Estén has, you know, one of the like artists whose work has inspired me through the years. It was really, really special to be able to work with her on this. On this wanted piece over here, the Virgen, which when it came down to work, you know, when she had this idea, you know, she really would have been looking at what was going on with SB 1070 in Arizona. So to me, it was really special to be able to work with her. But then also, I want to really give thanks to Malakias for saying yes to work on this exhibit with us and create the image that he did for the postcard and for the poster that you see over there by the entrance. It was, you know, it's really special to have that. To have that backing from that generation. Yeah. Do you want to say some stuff, Mark?
Yeah, I just want to say thank you to everyone that came today. I think a lot of our practice and the practice of having a taller is about building community, and this is a beautiful reflection of that. Like all the relationships that exist here, this really makes me happy to see all the connection. You know, the thread that connects us all together. And I really feel like the work that we do, you know, all of us, all the generations, it really is about like that cohesiveness in our communities and our ability to see ourselves reflected as the beautiful, empowered community that has the vision for a better world. And so I also just want to give props to Jesus, who really led this process and really had the vision. And also say congratulations to him, because he's been accepted into a master's program. It's really great to see Jesus, you know, coming to the forefront, which is funny, you know, it is quite the flip. It is the work of the generations before, the Chicana feminists that have gotten us to that place. But I do want to give Jesus his due props, because this wouldn't have been possible without him.
Yes.
Our labor as artists. I think sometimes, you know, people forget, especially all the artists in the room, the hours and hours of our labor and our work that we create, whether it's making prints or building institutions. And often I think art is seen as something that just magically appears, and yet it doesn't. It is just, from generation to generation, this is our work, and this is how we contribute. And at the same time, this is a tool that really allows people to imagine something else. You know, I think especially right now, you know, there's people talking about immigration reform and gay marriage, and, you know, the policy fights are happening. And art is that space where we can really visualize what real equity looks like and what justice looks like. And so, you know, the work we do is so aspirational. I remember when I was first seeing Esther's prints, I was like, wow, I never even could imagine seeing myself, because, you know, whiteness was such a norm that even it was a revolutionary act to just say, we're beautiful, we're here, and this is our vision for the kind of society we want to have. So just, you know, standing in that room and just looking at everything, it's like, wow, just the toil and the labor that went into this, and that we really stand thanks to what you all built. And let's also remember, there was a war on our people. I mean, you guys saw the Assata Shakur thing, that the FBI, the COINTELPRO had a war against our institutions and our people. And so we are here to kind of reclaim that and to fight for us to love each other, or love our community. So thank you for all those who helped establish that and really built the
started kicking ass. We didn't own the wall. We didn't own the TV. We didn't own the radio. We didn't own the newspapers. So between the murals and the printmaking was like the path that we found and we took to communicate, to connect up with the community. And now there are new tools with the computer and what have you. But more than anything, I'm just really, really proud of the work that the younger generation is doing and giving us a hand sometimes, you know, showing us our work with computers and all of that. But more than anything, but that you're keeping the work going for the community and talking about all of the issues that are, you know, is still devastating us, and you know, and then celebrating our lives and our culture too. So I'll leave it at that.
Well, I just want to thank Julie and Melanie and Bobby for when they asked me if I would design the announcement poster. Well, it was an honor for me, because I think when you're a teacher, you want to teach all that you know to your students, to the people around you, because you know they're going to take it and then turn around and teach you. Because teaching is cyclical, I think. And I think now the inspiration that I get from these young artists is very, very moving. Although I continue to do my work, and stuff, every time I see their work, it's just amazing. I'm computer illiterate, and I like it that way. Because sometimes I ask students, do you have a T-square? They don't know what a T-square is, and that I find is very sad. We've become enslaved, I think, to technology sometimes. That's, no one knows how to draw hardly anymore. You know, everything is... And there's something so neat about the drawing, the ability to look and see, other than just a computer in front of you that you're looking at, but to walk around, to see things, to see the shadow of a building, creating a design element on the other side of the street. Those things we don't do that anymore. We don't see, we don't look at things. And I think that's the thing that the only thing that I sort of feel bad about what's taking place today. A friend of mine the other day, a couple years ago, Doug Minkler, people know Doug Minkler, some of you. He was talking about that he did a poster for an organization that was doing work in Palestine. They contacted him. Can you do a design? He did it on the computer. He sent it to them. They sent back almost immediately, can you change this? Doug did the changes, sent it back. They said, thank you very much. And he said, and my idea, the poster went out. And he said, yeah, but afterwards I thought, I didn't even get a handshake. No one even said, great, you know, they shook their hand, you know. And that was the thing that he sort of felt bad about. And that's how, you know, there's, talleres were set up to organize communities. It was to speak communities, not necessarily to create millions of posters, you can reach millions of people. It was to create, the most important thing was to bring the community, bring the parents, bring the children, and talk about why Jesse died, why the war is no good, why the price of gas is up. Those were the things, and you could do it in the most innocent way. Mira, senora, cut the stencil this way. Johnny died the other day because he was shot by a police officer. We're doing nothing, senora. And she doesn't feel like I'm preaching to her. We're just talking. Yes. You know, like compadres, comadres, and stuff. But, needless to say, I'm inspired by the work that these people do. Calling all of it's just amazing. So, and what? What, how many more years do we have? I don't have any more years, but so mine enough. So, gracias. And thank the older than I was who were here.
It's too late.
Okay, so as you know, we have the limited edition.
Next time.
I'm providing the poster prints designed by my lecturer. We're going to be applying out. You guys are going to take it down.
Oops, I'm sorry.